going to show you a quick metric, and you can select it, and go ahead and drop it down. This is following a sit-out. I'm going to kind of stay up because my mobility is not as great as it was one time. As they say, I used to be agile, mobile, and hostile. Now I'm just hostile. Okay, now when you get out here, you can underhook, I don't know if you're familiar with that, sucking back, or you can underhook one side and pull his chin back. And the best way, in my opinion, is to beat him right here. You just come across the face and use your head. Okay, just hollow. Okay, tap it. Okay, it doesn't take much pressure. So when you do this, be very careful with it. Okay, let's turn around so we just get a different picture here.
You okay, Sam?
Yeah. And, okay, just turn the man's head. You're pulling here, pushing here, and sliding it back. It doesn't take much.
Push. I want to just address a couple other things here before we go on, and that's the mental factors, the mental portion of this, because there's a mindset here that's very important. Basically, if you think you can or can't, you're right. But that can has to be on well-based confidence. In other words, you can't just say, hey, mentally, I'm going to kick this guy's butt, you know, without doing some training. You've got to do the work in the gym. That then will help the confidence factor. You have to do the training, the running, the wrestling, the repetitions of all the things that you do, the strength work, the total package. And then a lot of times we did this with Owings, and it worked very, very well. We noticed that Gable did certain things and exposed certain weaknesses that we wanted to take advantage of. Not that Gable had many. He was a very, very good, very fine wrestler. And I think that if he'd wrestled Owings 10 times, he would have won 9 of them. It just happened to be that particular day was Larry's. But the best time to do this, I know some of you are into the Zen philosophy, but a very good time to do it is just prior to going to sleep, when you're relaxed. You know, you can visualize yourself doing the front face locker, some particular move you're working on. But be a realist, too. If you wrestle some guy and he beat you, don't say, well, hey, that guy beat me, I had a hangnail, you know, or I had a cold or something. You know, why did he beat me, you know? Look for the real causes of it, and then eliminate those weaknesses, and next time maybe you'll turn it down. But you have to be realistic. This is a very realistic sport. And if you have a coach that's realistic, well, he might get on your tail once in a while, you know, hey, you know, you're not doing this, you're not doing that. So these are very important things. The mental aspect is very important. It's going to go through the double wrist lock, which I see there's a couple of guys here that work it very, very well. I've seen one boy do the switch and he turned it right into a double wrist lock. He said he'd been doing submission wrestling. So, but I want to point out two or three things in this regard. Okay, now, if this man's arm is straight and close to his body, I don't have much chance of making this a good move. Let's just walk around. In other words, if he keeps this thing close to his body and straight, now I can't do anything with it, you know. So that's one thing. Okay, so if someone gets it on you, well, that's part of the move, you know. Or you can pull in and grab the skin in your stomach or something so they can't get it up. Do you follow what I'm saying? Just grab something so he can't get loose. Okay, so lesson one. Okay, the second thing here, now relax a little, is get a little angle in it, bend it, you know. So there's an angle. You see what I'm saying here? Angle-wise, in other words, this is straight, 180 degrees. This is an angle. You have better leverage there. Third, if you can, take the palm and twist it, or twist at the wrist. Can you feel the difference? Mm-hmm. Okay. Or down here. Mm-hmm. I know this is quite a bit of stuff. So let's try this. Okay, we're going to be... Let's walk around one more time. Okay. Straight, not so good. Bent, better. With a twist, even better, because it takes the slack out. Or you can twist down to here if you can. Turn the guy with here, this line, we're just basically going to go to the key line. So, but the weight on his chest. So, Jake,
yeah.
You're working for pinfalls here too?
Yep.
Yeah. So you know, you're here, you weight on his chest. There's different things you can do here too, but we just work for a pinfall.
But with the shoulders down there.
Yeah.
And your legs on your weight on your toes.
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah.
Just shorten it out. Weight right on the chest.
Yeah.
There's different things you can do here too. Show you something that helps because you may not have a lot of power. Now let's say that I'm in this position and I want to get this guy's arm down and he grabs his stomach or something like that. So I can't, you know, it's too strong. Now if I can use a little trick to get him down without much strength. So what I'm going to do, hang on. You all right? Pull, push.
Yeah.
We're going to destroy one of the legs at the table. If I take this leg out, he's vulnerable, can move. And so we're going to be in here. And his head fry, lift it here, drive his arm down, do that. Now I'm through. You bring his arm into a hammer lock. Now, we're across here. Now at this point, this is where you've got to be careful. Start moving this arm away. Can you feel that?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. It is very vulnerable. Can you just go ahead and turn? Okay, come on back. Here it is. We're moving his arm out. out from his body.
So they turn
it's very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Okay. It usually they submit. Okay, this next one's a head and arm. We're going to do this in steps. The setup first, it's from a closed collar and elbow position, you know, when you're tied up. And I'm going to demonstrate two or three times in steps. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do here is shoot my arm past his head and try to use my deltoid of my shoulder to hit him right under the nose, to pop his head up. Okay? I'm not going to apply it too hard. Okay. So, we're tied up. I'm going to shoot the arm through, try to use the deltoid, top of your shoulder, to hit him right under the nose area, fairly tender area. Okay, so that's step one, just the setup. Okay, so let's just go here. Easy. Okay, I shoot through to this point. We're going to shoot the arm through, pop him with the elbow. Okay, right to the mat. And as we go down, this is just a simple arm and neck hold. But on the way down, if you can hook this, are we okay here?
Yeah.
Okay, and then take the head that way. It's very simple, very easy, very quick hold. If you miss it, you're still in pretty good shape. You know, with just a head and arm. You're still in third shape here. You know. And on this, you cross your legs this way, it's hard. If I'm here, he can't reach with his legs and grab my leg there and hook me and take me over, you know, and reverse things. So we're here, cross your legs this way. I can't do that. Okay, this arm is going deep there. Okay, give it a try, take it easy. Okay?
Thanks, sir.
Sometimes called a chest area. I don't know what the origin is of the move. I think it may have came, there was a former world champion named Tom Jenkins, and this is prior to the turn of the century, and later he coached at West Point, but I've never seen this hold published, and most people don't have a clue as to what it's about. But it's a very tight move. And I don't have the agility that I used to have. I can't move quickly, but you start from this position and you move behind the man, and I'm going to up the end of the leg a little bit. I come clear around and hook the arm. So I've got him hooked, just grabbed here and here. Okay, stay up. Now, I'm going to be pulling this arm back toward his crotch, and I'm going to be pulling this arm. Now, for yourself, once you break, you hear yourself walking, you want to step in left.
Yeah,
good. You all right?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Wait a minute. Stand up.
Yeah, so you can see where it's ripped.
Yeah.
It's a lot of pressure.
It's a terrifically hard move. Sorry, Bob. You
no problem. One more time.
Please. It's hard to do this in an easy way.
Nice.
Basically, you're here. You're pulling this arm diagonally toward this hip. You're around here. And the pressure doesn't come from me squeezing. It comes from the twist that he gets in the ribs. When it starts to hurt, hollow a little bit. So, you know, so they can kind of tell what it's getting tight. Okay, it's here and here. Now I'm pulling here, now I'm starting to walk. I'm going to let you down. I took it a little too far, but it's very tight. Could you tell?
Oh, yeah.
Very good. Thank you.
Just a couple of, it's kind of a little fun stuff, actually. If I hook the man here, just like this, can you see this at all?
Yep.
Okay. If he turns in.
You should spin around him.
Okay. If he starts turning in, you just take him right, let him come right with it, and keep turning. Okay. And then, we're in a pretty uncomfortable position here. So we're just like a twisting chicken wing. Can you see what's going on there? Or?
Yeah, if you can't see, move around, guys.
Yeah, okay. Just try it. It's just kind of a little fun thing. If you're hooked here, just slowly do it. Okay. Now, if he turns in, then you chicken wing him. You know, keep turning. You let him come. Oh, that's right. If he turns, if he turns away, you key lock him. So if he turns this way, can you feel that at all?
Yeah.
Yeah. I just got a simple key lock. You listen to this. You just roll your wrist. Okay. If he turns this way, turn slowly. I don't want to bang here. You right here. Simple little move.
Armbar.
Yeah, just an armbar.
Maybe we see one more time, please? Mr.
Sure. Okay. Sure. Okay, we're here. If he turns that way,
turn out.
Turn this way.
To your left.
Yeah. So. Then you drag it out and she locks. You can feel this roll in your wrist. It hurts.
What?
Uncomfortable.
Key lock, short arm.
Then you arm bar. Use the head too. Very, very uncomfortable. All right, simple. It's effective.
Thanks, sir.
Did you do it?
Yes.
Joe Stecker, interlace him here if you can. Can you? I've got some big, it's hard to pronounce. Anyway, Stecker was going to fight a guy named John Pesce. And Stecker was very, very good at the body scissors. You've probably read about Joe Stecker.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, he was very good at it. Well, anyway, he devised this move. I don't know if I can do this guy or not. You get right over when the guy has a rear body scissors and you come down pretty hard. Are you okay here with this?
Yeah.
Okay. And you just come down pretty hard. Your legs are too short. I doubt that. But basically what all you're doing here is stepping over and then driving down. And it's kind of an uncomfortable thing, particularly if you ballistically move into it. So I just thought I'd pass it on because I see in the ultimate fighters, they're in that position a lot. Of course, they're trying to choke the guy. So I just thought I'd pass that on while I'm here. This is just a little basic move from a reverse bar. I've got this guy down, and I'm going to come right through and hook this arm. And then, he says, ooh. That's right. It's like a full Nelson, only you're not doing much. You're just laying it. If I bounce into this guy, I could hurt him. Simple move. You're here, you've turned him, just drive through, and then if you lay back, I'm doing nothing except laying on it. Uh, whether you're a great wrestler, a good wrestler, whatever kind of wrestler you are, I always respected whoever I was wrestling with. Even the guy was a fish, where I still, if the guy had enough guts, he didn't give it a shot, but, you know, he's deserving respect. I just wanted to point out just a couple of drills, switching and re-switching. So if you guys just demonstrate what we're talking about here, we just go on, I'll say ready and whistle. Ready, switch, and re-switch, and switch, and break it down. Gents, I'm done for the day. I very much appreciate it.
Fall back so the other guy comes down and tends to these and
you know what you're going to do, so just fall back, flatten out down here if you're short, and then just stand up.
Okay.
Can you follow what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Start, you don't have to hurry on. Start bringing it.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
you got it down here, you're going to go left.
Nice. Now, are there any tricks, just a question, talk about him down here. If he's a big guy right there, he wants to keep his elbow there. Are there any tricks to get him underneath there, like popping?
Well, driving in there,
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, so that's really good.
fighting to the side, so.
What do you want me to know? Okay, where you want me to just be here?
Okay. Come to the hands and knees, and as he comes out, insert your leg.
Okay.
Insert your left leg.
Yep.
As he comes out, then you, yeah, very good. Okay?
Yep.
That's fine, yeah. It's just a way to get in there sometimes, you know what I mean?
Oh, that's good, yeah.
Because if the guy's up, it's go ahead and come on up.
Oh, sure, okay.
Okay, now, go ahead. If he starts to insert the leg, just bring that on the back, see?
Oh, okay.
And fly. That's how we do all the stuff. Keep him out.
Yeah.
But it's a good place to insert the leg. You insert the knee aside.
Right.
Go ahead, fly him out of the air and hit the strata, just here on top of him. Okay, come on up to your knees now. And Rick, you put both of his in there.
So we break the guy down with the power half. and orally, like step down my shoulder. I mean, if you're just,
I guess
I'm there's no way to, yeah, this is better.
Yeah,
the other way, there's no way to focus.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. So if I did that, I just get on the inside of the side, and then the inside of the side here, and then just get my hips into the ground.
That's right, I'm just forcing you to do this.
Yeah, now I can take the arm I want, yeah, my leg, whatever.
You just have to be ready. I can sit up and switch.
Yeah. One of the things I always like doing from here is getting the one arm trapped.
Yes.
And then doing the same sort of thing with Nelson.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you do the same thing there. Yeah. You can use this.
Oh, yeah.
Start, you know, just
rib a few times.
Yeah.
You know, so the guy says, well, what if he gets mad? Well, if he gets mad, so what? You're getting a rib. Head also when you have your key lock.
Oh, right, yeah.
You can just walk around.
It's just kind of a resting position. It's just in here with your arm, right? And basically, everyone, you know, he's got a right angle here.
Yeah.
So, and you're on him, you want to be right on him. You notice my weight's on my toes. So, his weight's here. Now, the reason that they're on your toes is it's easy to hear because it's kind of a rest position at the top. And if you're on him here, why, you know, he's carrying more weight. Can you feel the difference?
Oh, yes.
Here and here. So, just with weight. So, and right angle. So, you want to maintain that right angle. And you have to be careful here because if this foot gets out, you can reach over and scissors it
right.
And drag it across. So. Okay, and this is what I want to do. Let's see. One here. Okay. Now, if you're in here, this position occurs a lot. It starts to turn in so you can cut a hook here. Okay, now, the hook.
Oh.
Can you feel it?
Yep.
But just a key lock. And you can roll your wrist, see, when you start doing that, it doesn't look like much, but it's pretty devastating. So if it turns away, that's what you do. In other words, hook here, if it starts to roll that way, then just let him go and kick him down. If it comes into you, turn in. When you're in here, if I'm actually in, I'm under pressure in that joint, I start to roll on that.
Oh, and then you roll the other way.
It gets uncomfortable.
Then hold on to his arm and you sit out.
Yep.
Okay. So
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. This takes a while to get.
Yeah. It's in there. Elevate first.
Elevate his arm. Get in there and keep it elevated. Okay, then take it right out. Oh, there. Does he have it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Here.
Oh, I'm finished. Oh, you're here.
Sure.
Let's get the color.
this.
Now, see where we got this thing?
Yeah.
And then you take the head this way. Easy on his arm. It doesn't take much because you can break his arm when you're here. I used to use this quite a bit. A takedown right to this move.
Yeah, that's excellent.
It's a good move and it ends the match.
Oh, Yeah.
Quick take, y'all.
No, that's good.
Just the guy's grab. Okay.
Oh, there are.
Yeah.
The dude's grabbing on.
Look and sit.
Okay, I'm going to move it out. It's going to be down here.
Make sure you figure it out. Yeah, make sure you turn.
Okay, and see you over real quick.
Look, he's on.
This.
Yeah. There's different ways to, it's tough for the top man. The top man's got to touch his head.
Yeah.
They're really powerful.
Yeah. Now, if you're sitting up,